Okay, so the question is lactose sugar? The answer is yes. Lactose is a milk-derived sugar, but adding it to your beer will not add any fermentables to your alcohol content as well. Lactose is not fermentable by yeast. Yeast cannot assimilate it. So whatever you're going to throw in is only going to add to the mouthfeel of the finished beer. There will be no other increase in alcohol or any of those effects. So yeah, hope that answers your question. Next question. Now the next question comes regarding protein rests in malt. Now, you have to understand that way back in time, it was necessary to do very complicated step mashes because of the poor level of modification that most malts had. However, that is not the case today, especially with Castle Malting's malts. The only time you'd really sort of consider a protein rest is if you're doing a, if you're mashing with a high level of wheat or high protein adjuncts in the beer. Those are the only times you'd really consider doing a protein rest. Other than that, it's absolutely not required. Our malts are fully modified to a very advanced level, as well as the fact that our malts are chosen specifically from barley that has a low protein content, the spring two-row barley, which we chiefly make most of our malts from, excepting, of course, our distilling malt. Hope that answers your question. Next question. Okay, now, the decomposition of diacetyl is not really a yeast strain thing. I mean, if there's no particular yeast strain that will consume the diacetyl at a better rate. Getting rid of diacetyl is pretty much exactly as it always has been. It's pretty much, as soon as your fermentation is nearing an end and most of your sugars are consumed, taking your yeast up to warmer temperatures. For instance, let's say you were fermenting at 10 degrees, you could bring it up to between 16 to 18 range for 24 hours, 48 hours. That will allow you to assimilate all the diacetyl and leave your beer tasting clean and crisp. So there's no yeast out there that is specifically for eating diacetyl. It's more of the circumstances that the yeast is operating in that would have your assimilation of diacetyl at a higher rate. And I hope that answers your question.